Thank you for taking the time to join us for this short webinar looking at optimization from NAG. This particular example looks at the optimization of share portfolios from Excel. Here we're looking at a solver that solves linear constrained convex quadratic programming problems. This particular routine is E04NCA. But do bear in mind we have plenty of other routines in the library for solving optimization problems, such as nonlinear problems, subject to nonlinear constraints, large sparse problems, linear programming problems, problems with integer constraints which are non-smooth, and global optimization routines. But for today, we'll focus on a very simple example based on Markowitz theory for share portfolio selection, where the task is to minimize risk across a basket of shares. If I go now to the Excel workbook and look at the front sheet, which is the core data we're using for this demonstration, if I zoom out on this for a moment, we have here 7 years worth of real-world share data for just a small basket of shares which we wish to optimize. Looking at our results, which is based on that data, we can then call the NAG routine from Excel by clicking the Optimize button, which immediately provides here the optimal portfolio of shares. Notice negative values are allowed because shorting is allowed in this model. So for example, if we drop the return down lower, we get a different portfolio selected. What I'm going to do now is open up the underlying program and then pass you across to my colleague who can talk in some detail about what is going on within the program.
So here we are in the declarations module, and you'll see here that the developer has copied into this module the declare statements which NAG provides, and these declare statements correspond to those routines which he's going to use in his application. Things to point out in this here are that this library here, which I'm indicating, this indicates the library that's going to be used by the developer. In this instance, it will be the Fortran library, and to be using the NAG version of that library. The parameters are then listed as though they were written in Visual Basic. So, for example, here, the parameter n is introduced as a type long. In the Fortran library, this would have the type integer. So other things to point out whilst we're here are these two option statements. We recommend the option explicit because you'll know that all of these parameters, n, m, all have an explicit type. Variant would not suffice. And so you must declare your variables that are handed to a NAG routine, and they must have the type specified. We also recommend that the user use option base 1, and we'll see that later. But basically, if you don't put option base 1, then Visual Basic starts its arrays at 0. And in some senses, that's a little bit unnatural because we need to hand on arrays as the first element. And I personally prefer to hand on arrays starting from 1. So let's now move on to see how the writer of this demonstration has used the NAG routines. And to do that, we'll go to the module optimize. So if I first of all draw attention to the fact that again, the developer has used option base 1 and option explicit. And we'll scroll down. you'll notice that he's declared, he's given himself various parameters, all explicitly typed, and various arrays, and he basically takes information from the worksheet and puts them into those arrays. Scrolling down a little bit further, we see the very first call of a NAG routine. E04WBF is an initialization routine for E04NCA. And if we just dwell a little bit on the parameters, you'll see the first element here is a string telling it it wants to initialize E04NCA. And the second parameter here, the 6, refers to the number of elements in the string. So you'll see that we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 elements in the string, and that is how we get that number 6. So after a string, we always follow it by the length of the string. Now, the other thing to notice, I've mentioned this before, is that arrays are not passed as array arguments as such, but as the first element of the array, and storage association is used to associate the array with the corresponding elements in the Fortran routine. If I scroll down a little bit further, we'll see a number of option setting routines called. Here we're saying, well, don't if I set some options, don't print them out. I don't want any noise in my demonstration program, so keep quiet about that. And you'll see that no list is again a string, and we followed that by the length of the string. We've defined the problem type. E04NCA is capable of solving a number of similar problems. In this instance, the problem we're going to solve is of type QP1. And so we set that option here, and that string has got length 16. And again, the array arguments are passed as the first element of the array. Well, finally, we get to the nitty-gritty of the problem solution, the call to E04NCA. Anyone who knows this routine will know that it consists of many thousands of lines of code, but the user can make use this routine very readily just by calling it with these arguments. Again, array argument passed as a first element. Hopefully the solution is obtained, but there is an error mechanism. Ifail equals 1 before entry says, I'm going to test ifail on exit to see whether or not I've worked. And we see here that the developer has done just that. All these error cases all refer to an error or potential error. If ifail is 1, then the routine has succeeded. So we've dropped through, and here we see what happens on success. The answer, the optimal port failure is in X, and the author of this routine has written that answer back into a Visual Basic array, which is subsequently passed on to the worksheet. So hopefully I've explained the nitty-gritty of how the NAG library has been used to solve this problem, and at this point I'll hand you back to my colleague to continue with the demonstration.
Thank you, that was very clear indeed. Just to recap, the NAG algorithm there is enabling the user to optimize this small portfolio immediately. And as my colleague touched on, these routines can be used for many other types of optimization as well. In addition to that, the mechanisms such as the ifail mechanism enabling users to make sure the rest of their code within the program is calling the routine successfully. So in this case, we've managed to optimize the portfolio. Select did the best basket of shares. Do bear in mind that the NAG library now consists of over 1,600 algorithms, including many optimization algorithms that I'd already mentioned, and that the library can be called from Excel, from MATLAB with the NAG toolbox, from R, Python, and many other environments, enabling you to do things like prototype in one area and then have access to the same routines from other environments for production use. Thank you again for the time you spent listening to this webinar. Do get in touch with us by any means with any questions at all.